Hi, let's discuss intermediate coordination. Compiler have 7 phases. First phase is lexical analysis. Second phase is syntax analysis. Third phase is semantic analysis, or called as syntax directed translation. Fourth phase is intermediate code generation. I already discussed lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. This is the fourth phase. And compiler can work in one passes or multiple passes. In two passes, we can divide compiler into two parts. One is front end and another is back end. So front end will give output as an intermediate code, and back end take that intermediate code, optimize it, and generate the target code. What is the advantage of dividing front end and back end? Let's take three languages like C, C++, and Java. Let there are two machines, M1 and M2. Suppose we are not using front-end back-end concept, we are not using two passes compiler, we are just using one passes compiler. Then for C, for first machine, you have to do lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis, intermediate code generation, code optimization, target code generation, all the phases for machine 1. Then again, all the phases for machine 2. Then for C++ also, for machine 1, you have to do all the phases. For machine 2, you have to do all the phases. For Java also, you have to do all the phases for machine 1 and machine 2. So what will be advantage by dividing front-end and back-end? Front-end is related with language, while back-end is related with the machine. Suppose you are using the front-end and back-end concept, then let three languages C, C++, and Java, and there are two machines M1 and M2. For C, you can just design the front-end, that is lexical, syntax, semantic, and intermediate code generation, and that you can attach with the back-end of machine 1, that is target code generation and target code optimization part. And that you can attach with machine to backend. So what will be advantage? You will not write this front end for every machine. Just you will write for C language, and that you can attach with backend of machine 1 and machine 2. For C++ also you can design the front end, and that you can attach with machine 1 backend and machine 2 backend. For Java also you can just design the front end, and that you can attach with machine 1 and machine 2 backend. So you don't need to repeat lexical, syntax, semantic, and intermediate code generation for every machine. That we are just doing for the language, and that we are attaching with different machine backend. So by this front end and backend concept, we are reducing the time, reducing the cost, number of code is also reducing. So the front end translates source program into an intermediate representation, while backend will generate target code from that. And what is static checking? Static checking is the type checking that included in semantic analysis. So what is the advantage of intermediate code? Why we are not generating directly target code? We are generating intermediate code, then optimizing it, then generating target code. So optimization is easy in intermediate code. Then second, retargeting is easy. Retargeting is facilitated. That is, compiler for different machine can be created by just attaching a backend for the new machine at the existing front end. So intermediate code give the advantage of retargeting. We can retarget with different machine with the same front end. We can just attach the backend of that machine with the front end. And intermediate code optimization is easy than target code optimization. There are different representation of intermediate code, starting from high level intermediate representation to low level intermediate representation. High level representation are close to source language, while low level representation are close to target machine. Syntax tree is an example of high level language that is suited for type checking, while low level representation are suitable for machine dependent tasks like register allocation, instruction selection, etc. And three address code that can vary from high level to lower level. That's why we use three address code widely, as it can vary from high level to lower level. So what is three address code? Maximum there can be three operand. like z is one operand, y is one operand, x is one operand. In one instruction, there can be maximum three operand. That's why name is three address code. And the choice of designing intermediate representation vary from compiler to compiler. There are different intermediate representation. Some are in non-linear format, some are linear format. What is non-linear? It may be graph, tree, syntax tree, DAG, that is directed acyclic graph, control flow graph is an example of non-linear intermediate representation, while linear representation are postfix code, three address code and SSA code. We already know what is syntax tree and what is postfix code. I will explain DAG, control flow graph, three address code and SSA code. One question was asked in GATE 2021. There are some intermediate code representation with symbol table was given and it was asking which is not an intermediate representation. So answer will be symbol table. Let's first discuss DAG. DAG stands for directed acyclic graph. We can say DAG is a variant of syntax tree. What is definition of DAG? A directed acyclic graph. Acyclic means there should not be any cycle. For an expression, identify the common sub-expression. What is common sub-expression? The sub-expression that occurred more than once is called as common sub-expression. So DAG can identify common sub-expression. Suppose A plus B plus C plus A. So here A is repeating twice. So A is a common sub-expression. So construction of DAG is similar to syntax tree. Before creating a node, we'll just check whether that node is present or not. If that node is already present, we'll reuse that. If that node is not present, we'll create new node. Let's discuss directed acyclic graph for expression. Expressions means some arithmetic expression. So a DAG has leaves corresponding to operand and interior node corresponding to operator. It is same as syntax tree. In syntax tree also operands are leaf while operator are interior node. But in syntax tree for every node there will be just one parent, but in DAG there may be more than one parent. I will explain through example how there can be more than one parent for a node. In a syntax tree for the common sub expression would be replicated as many times as sub expression appear in the original expression. This DAG not only represent expression more succinctly, it gives the compiler important clue regarding the generation of efficient code. So from DAG, we can generate more efficient three address code than constructing from syntax tree. Let's see one example. So the DAG for the expression A plus A multiplication B minus C plus B minus C multiplication D. This example I used from Ullman book. You can refer Ullman book for more detail. We'll create the DAG according to precedency. Bracket have higher precedency. So first we'll create for B minus C. We'll create one node for B, another node for C. And minus will be its parent. So after bracket, next precedence is multiplication. There are two multiplication and multiplication is left associative. So first we'll do this multiplication, then we'll do this multiplication. So first we'll do A multiplication B minus C. We'll create another node A and another node will be multiplication. For multiplication, one child will be A, another child will be B minus C. So this node stands for B minus C. Then again there is another multiplication B minus C multiplication D. B minus C is already there. This node stands for B minus C. So we'll not recreate it. We'll just reuse this node. This node is B minus C. So what we'll do? We'll just create another node D. And for multiplication, B minus C will be one child and D will be another child. So we'll reuse this node. That's why it is a DAG. In DAG, if one node is already present, we'll reuse that. B minus C was already present, so we reuse that rather than recreating. Now A multiplication B minus C is done. This node stands for A multiplication B minus C. And this node stands for B minus C multiplication D. there is a bracket for B minus C. Next, there are two addition. Addition is left associative. So we first evaluate this addition, then we'll evaluate this addition. Already we have A multiplication B minus C, and already we have A. So what we'll do? We'll just create a node plus, and for plus one child will be A, and another child will be A multiplication B minus C. This node is for A multiplication B minus C. So another child will be this multiplication. There is another plus that will add this left part with right part. This plus node stands for A plus A multiplication B minus C. And this multiplication node is for B minus C multiplication D. We'll add this two node. We'll create another plus, and for plus one child will be this plus, as it stands for A plus A multiplication B minus C, and another child will be this multiplication. Now this is the DAG for this expression. Here A is twice, but we just create one node A. B minus C is twice, we just create one node for B minus C. Just mark one sentence that in a DAG has more than one parent if N represents a common sub-expression. Here A is a common sub-expression, B minus C is a common sub-expression. For A, you can mark there are more than one parent. For A, one parent is multiplication, another parent is plus. So for one node, there are more than one parent as A is a common sub-expression. Then for B minus C also, for B minus C there are two parent. One is this multiplication, another is this multiplication. One multiplication is for A multiplication B minus C, another multiplication is B minus C multiplication D. As B minus C is a common sub-expression, so for that there are two parent. The HTT can construct either syntax tree or DAG. I already discussed how we can create syntax tree from HTT. Then from same, we can also create the DAG. So before creating a new node, we'll just check if same node is already exist or not. If same node is already exist, then we'll reuse that node. We'll not create a new node, we'll just use that node. In next lecture, I'll discuss some more example of DAG. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like and subscribe. Thank you.